We say, well, threats exist. What about vulnerabilities? So the vulnerabilities could be of many kind. For example, if you use a weak password, that is a vulnerability. Someone can guess that password and then be able to use that to launch an attack, which in this case would be taking control of your account. If they're able to take control of your account, well, that is a compromise of your account. If they're able to do it more broadly to a system, that's a security breach. So an attack is a successful exploitation of a vulnerability by a threat source, resulting in this system that has been compromised. Unfortunately, vulnerabilities are very hard to get rid of completely, and they can be found in software that runs on our computer systems, networks, and a lot of times the biggest source of vulnerability, people say humans are the weak link. We do things that actually introduce vulnerability into the systems. So the security mindset starts with threats, then we have to talk about vulnerabilities and exploitation of those leading to attacks. And attacks result in compromise and security breaches. We're going to use a really simple example. You can call it a trivial example to illustrate this idea of a vulnerability and attack. So many of us ride our bikes, and of course, it's an important asset to us. It costs money to get one. You know, it gets you around, so obviously it's useful to you. So it's a valuable asset. There are threats against it. People steal bikes. Let's think about if you just leave it anywhere, obviously there's a serious vulnerabilities in it. The thief can walk and take the bike away. So what we normally do is we lock it. So as you see in this graphic, this person who is security conscious actually has locked the bike. And they go off to class or to work or whatever it is. And you look at the system and you say, well, are there any vulnerabilities? Vulnerabilities, some we may actually know about, others may not even know about. It's the threat actor who actually discovers it. And in cybersecurity, we call them zero day. The thief actually is not going to fight the security you have in place here, which is a lock. Instead, what he's going to do is he's going to walk away with the bike minus the wheel. So the vulnerability here was that this asset that we have here, the bike, of course, the thief will have to buy a new wheel, but what he or she is able to walk away with is actually still fairly valuable, isn't it? It's most of the bike. Add a wheel and you have a functioning bike. So the vulnerability we never thought was that we had to secure more than just the wheel. Okay, the lock that we put is actually only protecting the wheel. It's not protecting the entire bike. That's the example of a vulnerability.